Good evening. Welcome back to Be Rich. Today, my good friend Adira is here. We are going to discuss some of the questions that you have asked us. So, let's get on without further ado to questions that you have sent to me. Welcome, Adira.
Thank you, sir. So, this time, the session is going to be like, I'll be telling who have actually sent the mail also. I'll be reading out their names also.
Mm.
So, the first question is from Paneer Selvam.
Mm.
He asks like, you ask them to invest in Tata Motors and there is Tata Motors DVR also.
Mm.
So he's asking, what's the difference between Tata Motors and Tata Motors DVR and which one is good to invest?
Okay. I have done a video in Hindi it was, but not in Tamil or English. I will do it in Tamil or English to explain what is the difference. But Tata Motors and Tata Motors DVR, the difference is voting rights. For every one share of Tata Motors, you are going to have one vote. Whereas in Tata Motors DVR, you need to have 10 shares to get one vote. In the case of Tata Motors, the Tata & Sons has the majority holding at 35%. So they will get any resolution passed. So there is voting actually does not matter. So it is better to buy Tata Motors DVR rather than Tata Motors.
Okay. And then we have another question from Sam Emmanuel. He asks, what's the difference between gold bond and paper gold?
Sam Emmanuel, the difference is this. Paper gold is actually the price of gold traded every day. So, you're actually buying the gold. So, you can trade anytime you want. In terms of buying a sovereign gold bond, RBI is making a bond and will pay you back after 5 or 7 years. So, you can buy the bond. They will give you an interest which is very negligible, 1 or 2%. And you can redeem it only at the time when the maturity comes. Then what they have now done is to get some liquidity, they have listed the sovereign bond in the market. So you can buy it from the market. But the problem is it always trades at a discount. If the price is 4,000 grams, it will trade at 10% discount or 5 or 6% discount. The discount varies. At times it can be 2, 3% discount also. Between 3 and 8% discount is there. In case of paper gold, whatever is the closing price in Zaveri Bazaar, the same bazaar price will be applicable. So you are actually buying gold here without the taxes. There you are buying a bond. So when you sell a bond, you will lose money. When you sell this paper, you will get the value on that day what it is. Whereas if you want the full value in a sovereign gold bond, you will have to wait for the RBI to redeem it.
And there are some people who also asks like, they are willing to invest in gold bond or paper gold. But then what they care is like, how will I take it back? Like, how will I redeem it? Like, does it come as gold or like how?
In gold bond, it will come as money on the day when it is, whatever is the value of gold on that day. In case of paper gold, you want to convert it to jewelry. You will have to sell the paper gold. The money will come to your account in 2 days. You can withdraw it and go to the jeweler and buy the gold by paying the tax plus the making charges.
Okay. Then we have a third question from Ratika. She says she wants to buy silver bar, but she says she doesn't get to buy silver bars in any shops or jewelry showrooms. But she asks like, where can she actually buy them?
My advice is you can go and buy it in the wholesale market. But my advice is don't trade in silver because silver is very volatile.
Mm.
There have been times when silver has corrected by 40% in a year. And silver has other uses than gold has very little limited uses. Silver has more uses in electronics. So demand supply will affect silver. Silver is not a great investment. It is better to stick to gold.
And then there's another question from Anandi. She asked, I'm investing in Tech Mahindra. And Tech Mahindra is gradually reducing now. She's asking like, what's the reason for it?
I've been invested in Tech Mahindra for a long time. I think I bought my first lot at about 300 or 350 many years ago. And from the so you cannot look at very short-term movements in prices. You have to give it 18 months. I have not checked the price of Tech Mahindra in 18 months. But in the last 18 months, Tech Mahindra has gone a big way. So maybe the price has gone too high. And then corrected. But by the time, I have not checked the price of Tech Mahindra. But I am sure this quarter results and the next quarter results of Tech Mahindra will be good. And whatever is the loss will be made up. And I don't know what period Anandi is referring to it. Because I just checked on my phone. Over last 6 months, Tech Mahindra has gone up from nearly 1000 rupees to 1705 today as we speak. So that's a 60% jump. I don't know where she got the data that Tech Mahindra has come down. So a 60% increase in 6 months is a lot of return. She would have beaten the index by a huge margin. I checked 1 month price also. It's moved from 1600 to 1704. So if you want to be an investor, you should look at a longer period. 1000 to 1704 in 6 months is a lot of return. But even if she's looking at a 1 month return, it's gone up 100 rupees and it will go up much further from here.
Okay. And then as you every month you give out stock recommendations, isn't it? And
No, I don't give stock recommendations. My team discusses with me, they send it. I am not a SEBI registered advisor, so I don't send out recommendations on my own. What happens is, let me explain. A lot of people send mails to us. We have a separate team handling that mails under Sheikh Abdullah. They have tied up with a broker. So they discuss with me on what I am buying. I tell Sheikh Abdullah what stocks I am interested in this month, what I am buying. And this is what I buy in regular small quantities. That list is being given to people who have opened an account with Sheikh Abdullah through the email. So it is basically people who have got an email and have got an account with us, with the Ionian or with that broker that they do with. They get the list. Yes, that is the list.
Yes. So now one of the client is asking, like, why do you always recommend Kalyan Jewelers and IDFC First Bank?
Because when I look at the relative questions, relative price to earnings ratio, IDFC has a very sound management. I know the guy who is running IDFC. He was originally in Citibank in Madras as a branch manager. And then he went places. He ran Aviva for some time. And then he ran an NBFC. And then that NBFC was very successful. And IDFC Bank was not successful. So they merged the NBFC with the bank. And he has only 2% of the bank in his name. So he's running it as a challenge. And I look at it, and now they have got a revolutionary product on credit cards. So I think over a long period of time, they will be the next HDFC in lending to credit cards and to consumer retail loan. They largely lend to retail people. And that's the biggest segment in India. And I think they will do a good job of it over a period of time. Relative, when I compare with HDFC valuations and ICICI valuations, I find this relatively cheap when I bought it, and that's why the recommendation. Kalyan Jewelers is, you compare it with Tangamail, where it's gone, you compare it with Titan. What happened is they priced it to perfection. That is, when they did the IPO, it got priced to perfection. So I started buying it when there was a discount to IPO. And I'm accumulating it. I have a large position. People who have come earlier, they would have known that we recommended Titan. We have also recommended Tangamail. Now, Tangamail went way out of cost. We recommended at 300 rupees. I think it's trading more than 1000 rupees now. Same thing happened to Titan. So these two have become too expensive. So I know for sure gold prices are going to go down. More Indians will buy gold. Therefore, this company will make a lot of profits in the future. So this is the reason. When I compare it with Titan and I compare it with Tangamail and I compare this, I find this relatively cheap. And I also see that Indians will buy a lot of gold. But these recommendations are my recommendations based on what I am doing. And this is no way a SEBI registered investment advisor's advice. So if you are going to act on the advice, better to talk to somebody. If you want professional advice, talk to somebody else. So thank you. And again, she'll come with another set of questions for tomorrow. Thank you for watching, Be Rich.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's a great privilege and honor that so many of you in thousands have subscribed to my channel and have supported me. I have written 2 books in English, The Alchemy of Money and Ordinary Stocks, Extraordinary Profits. These books are published by us and are ready. If you want to procure a copy, send us a message to the WhatsApp number given below and my team would respond to you. If you want an Amazon Kindle copy, you can click the link below. Finally, those who wish to consult with me can send a mail to berichenglish@gmail.com. Once again, I thank you for your support. If you like this video, press the subscribe button of my channel, hit the like button and turn on the bell notification.
For hot financial news reviews and economical updates, watch Be Rich. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel.